Hi, welcome back. Today we will be playing Norland. I've recorded this game a while back, kinda forget about it and finished editing it recently. I was, and still, preoccupied doing something else, so, I reckon, there will be new updates and new stuff when I finally upload this video. Now, we start the game, we select our family type and modify our stats. Here, we can choose our clan or tribe type. Let's choose Varns for now. Rename the king with our usual name, AceShinken. And I'll use some random stuff that come up for the wife and child's name. Maybe, let the father be the protective one so talent on combat, and the wife as the manager. And, maybe, the kid can focus on being the future manager. In this game, if you increase the stat, it will add some years, and vice versa. So, I'll make the king and queen young with just enough skills. I plan on playing the peaceful mode, and no hordes coming. So, I'll just play choosing the corner land here. Renaming my land, and modifying the banner a bit. As planned, let's just play it easy. Let's check the surrounding. I see some fertile land. There's a lot of trees. And also some mines. Let's start with the basics of all building games that has resources. Wood and food. Let's build a lumber mill and maybe some food farm. For me, this game is quite unique. Because you need to learn a knowledge before you can build something or craft something. You have to build a library before in order to learn those knowledge. You can gain knowledge either by interacting while giving instructions, like building upgrades, or buying those books from the merchant. Knowledge can also be acquired by talking to another lord, while other lord could also get our knowledge from talking to our lords. So it's a nice sharing community. Or, people can't just shut their mouth without sharing important national affairs to other lords. If you are a bit of a bad boy, just steal some books from other territory, while also getting a bad reputation to the matriarch, which makes trading more limited. The knowledge stays with the lord that has learned it. If they die, you need to learn that knowledge again in the library. The funny thing is, the lord only give instructions. And somehow the knowledge is already applicable in our realm, just, like, that. Well, I thought previously, the lord with the knowledge is the one that will have the effect on the corresponding effect. Correct me if I'm wrong, so my assumption now is, the knowledge learned by any lord is already applicable immediately after he learned it. So, either it's fertilizing or using armor learned by any lord, all peasants will utilize that knowledge after the lord learned it. Like that? After building the farm, I plan to build another housing for the peasants, a tavern, learn more things to fulfill the basic needs of the realm. I plan to buy some books from the merchant and slaves when he comes, and the process of building and trading will repeat itself every day. And, there will be no commentary after this. Please comment anything, especially the thing I ask about the knowledge being applicable immediately after being learned.
You're a beggar. Dim ond al or silfoniad. Moon audora dao da yinonig. Eme neglausen. Still dig aren't all now when yard hien. Gwen tuskia lon o fta.
I'm going to go out. Near Granodeb, Yohidir, you know where I'll read it.
I'm gonna go out here if I'm on Grunaberg as a bit of a guy's golf. I'm gonna muggle it. I'm gonna go out here if I. I want to get a mug.
Dead. Snap fun re. Merk. Rutabag, I demand a roast Merkrai Nadab, I gaya here, yen or. Rutabaga, demon, arroz.
Well, that's all for this video. See you in next one.